This one? Yep. Perfect. And you are so dead. I wonder if I'm able to save him in time. Couldn't save the girl.
It's said that nobody knows what the future might bring. But for this man, it's no longer entirely true. A weaker man might simply give up, but the champion of light is an expert on destiny. Sometimes the puppet and puppeteer can be one and the same.
Desert Shore Motel. And the Red Tooth Observatory. Some of the Taken aren't directly protected by the darkness, and I couldn't read it. Went by too fast.
Man-made eyes that stare into the endless depths of space.
Didn't I already watch this?
The champion of light will depend on them to pick out a message from the ether.
The ether? What is he talking about now? Okay, I'm confused. Okay, there we go. You know, I wonder if there's a manuscript around here.
The man remembers the patterns. He knows
down here,
he
maybe?
The missing part for the telescope.
I better find Dr. Meadows' car. That's where the camera should be.
Let's get away from that. Okay, that was weird. I got near it and then it got all dark. Okay, we're going through the same stuff we did last time. Why? And there goes the lights. Open sesame. Turn it on.
Oh, praise be. You guys are coming through for me.
Let's try the shotgun. Let's try the shotgun. Oh, crap. Oh, my God. Why are you in here? Why are you all in here? Okay. Back up. Y'all are so screwed. Open that door. Go ahead. Come on, door open. I gotta get out of here. Whoa, that is a lot of red. Goodbye. Oh, the guy's still throwing darkness at me. Where is he? Can't see him. Where are you throwing these things from? There you are. Got you. Is he dead? Okay. I think I got him. Oh, nope. Come on. Okay, only a few more. Quickly, let's go. Let's go. Oh, guys, some guy popped up near me. Okay, I got the guy throwing those, like, dark, like, I don't know, bombs. Anyway, let's get away from here. That's the right way, but there are manuscripts back there. There are two of them right here. Okay. Let's keep going. I could have sworn there's some back here that I saw. Yep, there's one right there, right next to the ammo. Let's go and switch my gun back to the Magnum. Can I still get in here? Yes, I can. Where is the manuscript? Where are you? There you are. Okay. Oh, these are random ones this time.
The atmosphere in the projection booth at the drive-in was charged. Almost unreal. Despite.
I can read them. What? Wait, why are these all missing now? Oh, they're observatory ones.
As a storyteller, my first real love was crime. And it was in that genre that I finished my first novel, starring the perpetually miserable Alex Casey, whose entire life was a wound that never healed. The books sold as fast as they hit the shelves. I wrote 5 more Alex Casey books, and they all were bestsellers. I became rich. I became famous. Success brought pressure, and I didn't handle it very well.
Right. Well, I don't have the next one, so no point in reading it. Alright, let's get some ammo and some batteries. Go. Open sesame. It would have been nice if that door opened by itself, but no. It's gotta sit in my way like that. Actually, let's not use the pump action shotgun. Let's keep the magnum out for now. And I'm going the wrong way. I wanna go up the hill, but it's telling me to go over here. Can I open you? What do you have? Oh, you have a hunting rifle. Well, what does it take away? Does it take away my shotgun? Yeah, it does. But let's see what it does. I think it's the same as the carbine, probably. Just shoots slower. Oh, what are you doing? You ran away. Why'd you run away from me? And the car is at a different spot now. Okay, I got it. Let's quickly get out of here, because I know something's gonna pop up. Spiders, not this time. No spiders? Nope. Nothing? I hear something. Where are you? Birds. Don't be like that, birds. Oh, this shoots real slow. I gotta hurry up. Quickly reload it. And it reloads very, very slow. It better be strong. Oh, crap. Yeah, it's strong. That's about it. So it's strong, but it shoots extremely slow. Extremely, extremely slow. Its reload time's long, too. Okay, where are you? I heard you. Oh, I turned into a bird before I could get that second shot off. I keep missing because I'm trying to aim inside. Come on. There we go. Oh, crap. Get away, get away. Crap. Oh, crap. Not again. No. Okay, I'm switching to the magnum. There we go, that got rid of him. Okay, and that's all of them. Let's reload. Come on. Before I do, let's pick up the carbine again. Carbine's a lot more useful. Oh, a flare. And there's a manuscript. Come on, give me the manuscript. There we go. Okay, let me in. Quickly.
Yes. Is it? I suppose you'd better come in.
Quickly.
I'll unlock the door.
Thanks.
Let's go. I'm not trying to have this. Oh, wait, TV. What craziness do you have now?
I know what you're thinking. Evil twin, supernatural powers. But most of the time, I just like to keep things basic. I want you to understand that.
Sure. What do you got for me now? Oh, your death tools.
Like this. Need to get your hands dirty? No batteries, no moving parts, just physics. That's technology you can depend on. It's a classic.
No.
Speaking of classics, you need to be careful with this one, though. If the victim suddenly twists, you might end up cutting yourself.
Yeah.
It's not really a workhorse, but...
Okay, crazy.
I'm a sucker for this style. Now this is more like it. You've got slip-resistant grip. Believe me, you really want that traction once you're wrist deep in somebody. The blade's stiff enough so it won't open by accident in your pocket, but it's still really easy to open with just one hand. Now that's a big thing for me.
You know, I wonder if I could shoot the TV. Thinking.
It's too big. Too heavy. But sometimes
nope,
you
can't.
Just need the extra oomph. Talking intimidation. This
yep, definitely
is
can't
do the job. Also great for dismemberings and whatnot. You know. The messy jobs.
And what's next? The axe? Nope.
I can't
the
tell
duct
you
tape.
How many things I've MacGyvered with this stuff. Okay, now guns. Not a big fan.
The pistol, of course.
How are you supposed to really connect with somebody with a bullet? I want you to understand that.
This was very fascinating.
I take pride in what I do. We can't.
I see you do.
Worthless hacks, can we?
Yeah, we can. Stuttering again. Okay, crazy. Crazy.
You'll have to forgive quickly. Me, but this feels very strange. It seems like this has all happened before.
I have the replacement part for your telescope, Doctor.
Let's get it installed.
Quickly. Now, the cooling system's working, though. Do I have to go back and fix those as well? Look at me, a professional telescope fixer. The Hero of Light, a mechanic, and a writer. There we go.
I think we can give this a go, although I have this strange feeling that something
Don't
will go
start
wrong.
It up yet. There's a problem with the cooling system.
Yes, that's right.
Am I gonna go fix that?
That is why you're here.
There's something
it?
Over here.
Yes, it is. I'll take care of it.
Before you go, if you have the time, I'll teach you to come here and explain it. This is very strange to me.
I'll do that in a second once I find this manuscript, which is hiding from me. Where are you hiding? It's like somewhere in this building, but I can't seem to find it. Okay, come on, blink again. Okay, now it's below me. It's like outside the building or something. I don't know, I'm crazy. Okay, I don't need the ammo, but might as well get some. Nothing wrong with extra ammo. Especially when it's limited. And I got some flashbangs. Those will come in handy when I fight the bigger enemies.
I don't quite know what's going on. But I seem to remember having had this encounter before.
It's not deja vu, Doctor. This has happened before. We're caught in a time loop.
That's utterly insane. How could that be?
I can't really explain it. I suppose I could call it magic.
I don't believe in magic.
Neither do I. But I can't argue with what I've experienced. Listen, what matters now is the signal. The last time we only caught a part of it. I need the rest of it. Whether you believe me or not, you want to look into this as much as I do, right?
Yes. All right.
I realize that you have trouble believing this.
That's an understatement. I can't deny that what you say resonates with me on some level I don't pretend to understand. But for all I know,
a scientist believing this, you know.
But it's not just you. I've experienced the same thing as you. Doesn't that prove something, at least?
Maybe. On the other hand, given your appearance, and the fact that you're trying to convince me that I'm not insane, perhaps you're merely a hallucination that accompanies my delusions.
You're not having a psychotic episode, Doctor. For what it's worth, I'm a skeptic by nature. I completely understand your reluctance to believe me.
There are people caught so deep in their psychosis that they retroactively manufacture memories and beliefs that conform to the situation at hand.
Stop being a scientist.
Sure, but you have to stop second-guessing yourself at some point, if you want to get something done.